Kathy Dixon here. Welcome to the Math Reflective, where we think deeply about math, how we teach, and how we might increase student and professional potential. Well, today I'm going to talk to you about how to work smarter, not harder, when scoring assessments. Stay tuned. So basically, it is the last few days of school, and I have assessments that my advanced math students took today. I teach sixth grade advanced math and standard math level. So I have about 75 assessments to score. I have to get my grades in the next couple days and pack up my classroom. So I'm feeling a little stressed and overwhelmed. And so I had a solution to this. I want to work smarter, not harder. And I still want to be fair and make sure that my students are scored correctly. But to give you a little background information, I'll tell you what. We are a school that still reports in percentages with our report card system, but in math for the last 4 years, we've been trying to implement a standards-based practice program. So we communicate with students on a 4-point scale, but how we have to translate that into percentages is kind of like fitting a square peg in a round hole. It doesn't really make sense. But our district is moving towards standards-based practice, K-8. So we've been piloting and working through this and doing the best we can with it. So I have communicated with students all year long what a 3.0 is, what it means to be a 4.0, and so on. We have criteria for success for the concepts and the units that we do. So students are fully aware of what is expected. So at this point in the year, my solution to work smarter, not harder, is this. Have students self-assess. So today's learning target was, I will be able to analyze errors and assess and determine my mastery level of the equations and expressions unit. We currently are in, or just finished, unit 6 in Open Up Resources 6-8 Math. We've been piloting this year, and we're going to be doing a second year pilot next year. I'm very excited because I love the way it's changed my teaching. But back to the standards-based grading practices. So what I did is I decided today that the students, I would pass back the assessments. A couple of my classes were not quite done, so they needed about 10 more minutes of class time. So I passed back the assessments and I gave them the choice of switching papers or grading their own. Of course, they all chose to grade their own. And what I do is I require all pencils be put on the floor whenever we're grading assessments together, and they have to take out a correcting pen. And then I go through the answer key and we talk through problems and answer questions about them, and I expect them to give their own feedback. So based on what the answers should be, they are recording feedback to themselves. I forgot, you know, the negative, I didn't multiply, or I should have divided. They're writing notes and interacting with their errors and analyze them as they go. That tells me, when I go to look over them later, how much they really understood of what they didn't know. This is a time that students can also ask questions. So after we're done going through all the items on the assessment, and I feel everyone has a better understanding of what the expectations were, I put it back on them. And I say, well, what does it mean to be a 3.0? In our system, I'm going to go ahead and attach our standards-based grade conversion for you down below in the description. But in our class and for our school, a 3.0 is proficient. And that means consistently meeting the Common Core state standard, with a few possible minor errors, not major errors. A 4.0, of course, is to be fluently meeting that standard with no errors. And then to drop it down 4.0, 3.0 to a 2.0, that would be a partially correct, or a student who's developing towards that standard but is inconsistent and requires support, and there's going to be many errors. And then the lowest score that we give is a 1.0, unless there's really a student who didn't really try and put anything on the paper. A 1.0 means that they require one-on-one support to be able to be successful. So we talk about, you know, those layers in between and what it should look like, but I don't give them that much detail, and sometimes they'll raise their hand and want to ask a lot of specific questions about each problem, like, does it matter if I put X plus 7 or 7 plus X? And those are usually the students that are really conscientious, and even though I had just said, remember, it's the commutative property, it doesn't matter the order, they still raise their hand and ask that question. And I try to value that in them, and I say, I love how conscientious you are, that you just want to make sure that you're following, you know, my expectations. But I also tell them, trust yourself. Trust that you know what the expectations are and what is correct and proficient and what is not. So I put it back on them to give me an approximate score of what they think they deserve. Now, of course, it didn't eliminate work for me. I'm working smarter, not harder, but I'm still going home and I'm gonna take these home today and I'm gonna go through each of the assessments and I'm really gonna evaluate and look at what their score was and look at the evidence. And then I will determine their final score. Some of them are a little bit harder on themselves than actually what their evidence shows. They're a little bit more proficient or closer to proficient than what they score. Now, I wouldn't always score assessments this way. Certainly, there is value in students knowing right away and getting feedback right away, but there's also value in me writing that feedback specifically for them. As always, we offer a retake, but with only 2 days of school left, I told them I'll have these in by 10 p.m. tonight. And our rules for a retake is that you have to have all missing work in, and usually you have to do extra practice to show that you're ready to master it, but in this case, since we're out of time, I will prepare a retake for tomorrow. If there are students that are completed with all their work and they're up to date, they're more than welcome to do a retake to score up to a 3.0, which would translate to a 90%. So we do feel that we don't really mind when they get it as long as they meet those standards. To us, it doesn't really matter. Well, I hope you enjoyed listening to how to work smarter, not harder, with scoring assessments. Please go ahead and hit the like button and subscribe to this channel for more videos to reflect on teaching. Thanks for watching. Are you ready for more?